Students, so today we are going to cover unit number 4, marketing management 2. So before starting this unit number 4, we will just have a quick revision of unit number 3, in which we discussed pricing, we discussed what are the various factors which are responsible for deciding the price of a product. We also discussed the pricing process, we discussed what is logistics, also we covered what is retailing, wholesaling, these all things we have covered so far. So notes I have already shared on WhatsApp group and through this Google group also. Hopefully you all have gone through with all those topics, and if you are having any problem, please come to me and we'll have a discussion over it. So now today we will start unit number 4, in which we will be discussing about various things such as promotion management, types of promotion, integrated marketing communication, promotion mix, all these things we will be going through. So this is the table of content. You can just have a look that these topics will be covered, and these all are part of unit number 4. So when we talk about promotion management, this is something related to when we have done the manufacturing of a product, we have done the packaging, that product is available, is ready for the customers. So we need to have a publicity of the product, we need to make the customers aware about the product that we are also available. We are providing various features, we are providing various things, so that the customers get attracted towards your product. So a company takes various measures in order to promote its product. So when I talk about promotion, it includes advertising, it includes personal selling, it includes sales promotion. What are these terminology that we'll discuss in the coming topics, in the coming PPTs, you can have a look over it. So when I talk about promotion, so as you can see the definition of promotion, it is a type of communication between the buyer and seller. Means seller is the one who is just making the product available to the customer. Seller is the one who is in touch with the buyer, who is just promoting its product, who is just convincing the customer to purchase the product, who is telling to the customers that why he should purchase this product, why he should not go for the substitutes. So as we talk about the market scenario, we are well versed that there are various substitutes available in the product, in the market of a particular product. Suppose I want to purchase mobile phone, so I know that there are various options. So it depends on me that which product I am going to purchase. So obviously it depends on the awareness which I am having about the particular model of the product. Also I am going to take a look on the word of mouth communication with my friends are telling me about that product. Suppose I'm going to purchase laptop, say like I don't have a good experience with a particular brand, say like Dell, so I will not go for repurchase. And also I'm going to speak negative about that particular product to my friends, and I'll be telling them that please do not go for this product. So this is the thing which we do by our own personal experiences. But another thing is how we are exposed to the information. Means it is, you all know that this is the scenario of digital marketing. So whenever you are going to purchase any product, you just do Google, you just search that what are the reviews of a particular product, what are the various features, pricing, you make the comparison between the substitutes as well, you make the comparison that which product is very much good for me, which is delivering me the maximum value. So these things we consider while purchasing a product. So as we know that the customers are well versed with the things, customer is floated with lot of information. So before purchasing a product, he considers various aspects of a product, and he also gives weightage to the pricing also, to the packaging also. He considers various things, and then only he takes the decision that whether I'm going to purchase this product or not. So companies are putting a lot of efforts just to convince the customers. So when we talk about the seller, he tries to persuade the buyer to purchase their goods or services through promotion. So basically we all know that if we are promoting our product, then our main objective is just to increase our sale, is just to let customer know that we are far better than our competitors. Obviously, this is our objective. So when I talk about Philip Kotler, as we know that he is a father of marketing, so he has also given a definition. He was like that promotion are all the tools in the marketing mix whose major role is persuasive communication. Means we are just going to persuade the customer anyhow. We have to just convince them that just purchase this product, this is good for you. So this is a thing which company is doing. Company is just providing the information to the customers that purchase this product, this is good for you. So, and if we talk about the objectives of promotion, we are just doing it for informing the customers. We are just doing to persuade them, means to convince them that yes, we are better than the competitors, so you can go for this product. Our objective is to remind them, just to give them a recall that yes, we are existing in the market, so you can go for it. So we are just going to give them the reminder as well. So these are the various things which covers in promotion. So basically we are just informing the customers about the product, that we are available in the market and you can purchase it. And also when we talk about promotion, we have to focus on one more thing, that is the customer value. If the customer isn't satisfied with the product, then definitely he will not turn up, that's for sure. So these are the various things which are to be considered in promotion management. Say like if you are doing very good promotion, the customers are well versed with your product, customer knows that you are existing in the market, but if they have a negative experience, then definitely they will not turn up. So these things are to be considered. So when we talk about promotion, it also helps the marketer to communicate information to potential customers. So when we talk about potential customer, this is the one who is willing to purchase a product. Potential means the customer who is having willingness to purchase the product. So these things we have to consider, that we have to analyze in the market who is the potential customer, the one who will be converting into customer in the near future. So we are just keeping a close watch, close eye on such type of potential customers, or we can say prospects. So now let's have a look over types of promotion. So when I talk about types of promotion, so there can be various types, as I already told you, advertising, direct marketing, sales promotion, all these things are there, publicity is there. Digital marketing, these are the various tools which a company is using nowadays in order to convince the customers. So when I talk about types of promotion, number one is advertising. It means to advertise a product, service or a company with the help of television, radio or social media. So when I talk about this thing, advertising. So advertising is something, means you are just showing your advertisement, you are making customer aware about your product through certain things with which the customer is, means a company is paying for it. So basically it is a paid form of communication, and in this we are not having a direct contact with the customer, but through, it can be through television we are in contact, through social media we are in contact. So definitely a company is paying for it. So this is something that through this particular mean, company is paying money for it, and company is trying to be in touch with the customer. Company is giving various information about the product by showing certain videos, by showing certain advertisement. It can be, sometimes company shows such type of advertisement in which there is a emotional appeal is there. So we have seen certain advertisement, like if I talk about this Idea Airtel, we have seen n number of times that they are selling their particular network with the help of emotional appeal. So basically sometimes by emotional appeal, sometimes by just having some affection kind of thing. So they just involve certain elements so that it can get touched to the customer, and customer feel likes to purchase it. So basically the advertising, it is a form of communication in which we are intending to promote the sales of a product or service to influence the public opinion to get political support or to advance a particular cause. So basically we are just advertising, we are just trying to convince the customer to go for it, to purchase it. Next, when we talk about direct marketing, it is a form of advertising where organization communicate directly to the customer through a variety of media, like we are just SMSing to them, we are just doing emails to them, we are having our own personal website on which we are just having a pop-up and through which we are just making the customers aware that we are also existing in the market. So this is something we are in direct contact with the customer. We are not involving any intermediary body. We are not involving any advertising agency for promoting our product, but we are in direct touch with the customer, as this term itself says, that direct marketing. So we have designed our catalogs. We are having certain database, so we are making a personal call to them that if you are interested to purchase this product, you can purchase it. As we have seen nowadays that we are getting a lot of calls from different companies. They are just convincing us. There are certain call centers, so they are just asking, are you interested to purchase this insurance plan? Are you interested to purchase car? Are you interested to purchase laptop? So they are trying to be in direct touch to the customer. So company, what it is doing is, it is just fetching the data of customers through various sources and just making a call to them, or just texting a message, or designing a catalog, and it is being sent to the customer. So this is also a way of communication with the customer. Next, we are having sales promotion. So when we talk about sales promotion, it uses both media and non-media marketing communication for a predetermined limited time to increase consumer demand. See, this is something we are already existing in the market. We are not new to the market. And we know that due to any reason, say like competitors are there, or we are having certain things that the quality is not up to the mark. So customer is switching to the competitors. So what we are doing in this case is, we are just offering certain attractive discounts, or we are just giving them certain things in such a way so that the customer is getting attracted. As the term itself says, sales promotion. So we are taking certain initiative in order to promote our sale. So this is something which is also used by the companies in order to promote the sales. So sales promotion, this is done by the companies when they realize that we are not doing very good in the market, and if we really want to survive, then we have to do something good. So it consists of diverse collection of incentive tools, mostly short-term design, to stimulate quicker or greater purchase of particular product or service by consumers or their trade. So the objective, as you know, that the main objective is just to promote the sale anyhow. So this is done with channel partners as well as the customers. So we are just convincing the customers to purchase our product. So this again plays a very much important role. Next, when we talk about public relation or PR, it is a practice of managing the spread of information between an individual or an organization, such as business, government agency, or non-profit organization. So we are doing certain things so that we can maintain good relation with the customer. So personal public relation is something we are doing, such things, so that we can maintain good relations with the customer. We can just have a loyal customer with us. So this is the thing also which various companies does, and this is something practiced by the companies on a regular basis. So it is also playing very much important role, and the companies are very much aware that if we are not going to maintain good relations with the customers, if we are not going to serve the society in a good way, then definitely the customer will not come to us, customer will not purchase our product. So companies are paying lot of money, companies are putting lot of efforts in order to retain the customer. Nowadays, the biggest challenge in front of the company is just to retain the customer. Anyhow, we have to retain the customer. If we are not putting attention to the existing customer, then definitely they will switch to the various substitutes of it. This is also proven actually that we are putting lot of money and efforts in order to fetch new customers.